Hello and welcome to this Kubla Cube 2019 tutorial on the new count length and area. Often people have said to us since we've arranged the site plans to do our earthworks takeoff, can't we do some basic length and area takeoff as well? And so we decided to add them in so our users could kill two birds with one stone. So the first thing to note about measurements is you don't need to use the measurements panel at all. You can carry on doing projects without using this. Kubla Cubed will, by default, export a number of useful measurements for the earthworks elements. So if you go into Create Spreadsheet, Earthworks Estimation, you'll find that it reports on the disturbance area, 2D and 3D areas, which is quite useful. Also, if you export the input data, you'll find that you get things like boundary perimeters and boundary areas. So for the measurements of the earthworks, you're probably covered by the standard exports. What this measurements panel is for is extra measurements that you might want to add to the project, like fences, curbs, or just areas that are sort of additional to the earthworks. So there's a decision to be made as to whether you add the measurements into the same phase as your earthworks or separate them out into their own phases. That entirely depends on how you want the report to look. If you wanted a special phase just for measuring fences, then you just create another phase, leave the earthworks empty and add measurements in there. Or if you want to, you know, do a few measurements that are included in an earthworks phase, that's okay as well. So you've got those both those options. So in this one, I'll add measurements into their own phase. So I'm going to hide the earthworks panel because I don't need it right now. So the measurements are really simple, what you would expect. So the count one, you just click along for adding new points to the count. So here I'm just counting how many parking bays are there on this side of the parking lot. We'll just go down, so it's just left click, just like creating earthworks elements, and then when you're finished you either right click or press enter. And you can see that it's counted 1 to 20 parking bays on this example. There's some styling options here where you can change the main color and you can change the text. You can also change the bracket style if you like. The reason why you'd do this is if you had a number of different counts and you wanted to visually separate them in the design view. And that goes for the length and area element as well. You can change the colours to separate them out. It's also a good idea to name elements. So I'll name this one parking lots. Parking lot count, maybe. And then it will appear in the report as such. So moving on to the length element is quite simple. Works very much like a ruler. So you're just clicking around here, and then when you want to finish, you just right click. It will display the length in a label on the line. So this one's 143.14. You can also have the option, if you want to measure a perimeter, of closing the line. And just like the counts, it's got these styling options. So I might change that one to green just to demonstrate. So I might make that one green. If you use this button here, it will link the text color to the main color, which is sometimes quite useful. So quickly moving on to the area, I'm going to measure this flower bed. So just like all the others, you just left click, and when you're finished, just right click, and you should see that it displays an area 112.60 meters squared for this one, and you can change the styling. And for this one, you can change the hatching as well. So the default is backward diagonal. I can choose to have cross diagonal or large dots, and you can turn it off as well if you don't want any hatching in the within the area itself. So that's all there is really to the measurement elements. The final thing is to think about is the export. So when you go File and Create a Report, or Create a Spreadsheet, or Export to CAD, the measurements will be exported to those files. One thing to note is in the Create Spreadsheet and the Create Report, the measurements don't have any presence in the earthworks estimation because they have no effect on the earthworks at all. So you'll find them in the input data report. So for example, if we go to the spreadsheet and go to input data, you'll find the measurement elements listed with the earthworks elements, so parking lot. It's got type of count and a feature count of 20, center line 143.14 for the length, and the area has got its boundary 2D perimeter listed and its boundary 2D area listed. This is the same for earthworks elements. If your earthworks and measurement elements are in the same phase, you'll find them all listed together like this. So maybe there's one more thing that I might mention, is that when you're doing area elements, it's probably a good idea sometimes to have boundary snapping turned on. So if you do join two area elements together like this, you can snap them. This can be quite often useful for measuring different regions. So like, I'll demonstrate how you can change the color to get a good visual separation between those two areas. So that's the end of the tutorial. As usual, if there's any questions, just post in the comments or feel free to post on our forum. Thanks for watching.